Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Wassalatu wassalam ala Rasulihil Nabiyyil Kareem. Amma ba'd. قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كل بني آدم خطاء وخير الخطائين التوابون وكما قال عليه الصلاة والتسليم عطاء رضي الله عنه he narrates that me and عبيد بن عمير رضي الله عنه we visited عائشة رضي الله عنها And we asked her, أخبريني بأعجب شيء رأيته أو رأيته من رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. Tell us the most amazing thing you saw from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Hazrat Aisha رضي الله عنها, being the wife of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, always with the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, learning from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, she says, She stayed quiet for a few moments and she thought, and then she said that one day, one night, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Ya Aisha, tonight leave me alone. Tonight I'm going to spend my night in the ibadah of Allah. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he gets up, fatatahara, he makes wudu. Then he stands up, And he begins to perform salah. Aisha radiallahu anha, she says, فَلَمْ يَزِلْ يَبْكِي حَتَّى بَلَّ حِجْرُهُ The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he continuously cried and he kept on crying and crying and crying until his lap became wet. Then, فَلَمْ يَزِلْ يَبْكِي حَتَّى بَلَّ لِحْيَتُهُ The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kept crying and crying and crying until his beard became wet. ثم فلم يزل يبكي حتى بل الأرض. Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam kept crying and crying and crying until the whole ground became wet. Then Bilal radiallahu anhu, he went and he called the azan. After the azan, فلما جاء He came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. فَلَمَّا رَآهُ يَبْكِي When he saw the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam crying so much, he said, يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ لِمَا تَبْكِي Why are you crying so much? Allah has forgiven all of your past and future sins. He said, أَفَلَا أَكُونَ عَبْدًا شُكُورًا Should I not be a grateful servant? He said, Allah just revealed an ayah to me. Allah just revealed an ayah to me this night. وَيْلٌ لِّمَنْ قَرَأَهَا وَلَمْ يَتَفَكَّرْ Woe be unto the one who recites these ayahs, but he doesn't ponder and reflect upon these ayahs. What verses were they? The verses in Surah Ali Imran. إِنَّ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَاخْتِلَافِ اللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ لَآيَاتٍ لِّأُولِي الْأَلْبَابِ الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا وعلى جنوبهم ويتفكرون في خلق السماوات والارض ربنا ما خلقت هذا باطلا سبحانك فقنا عذاب النار Verily in the creation of the heavens and the earth and the alternation of the days and night there are signs for those who understand for who for those who understand who are those who understand الذين يذكرون الله قياما وقعودا Those who remember Allah standing and sitting and lying on their side. And وَيَتَفَكَّرُونَ فِي خَلْقِ السَّمَاوَاتِ Those who ponder and reflect upon the creation of Allah. Right after that, Allah says, رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاتِلًا This creation of Allah is not useless. It wasn't created in vain. Allah had a purpose behind everything that He created. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in this ayah, is telling us the importance of pondering and reflecting upon the creation of Allah. In other words, the way we understand it, the Prophet ﷺ is telling us the importance of meditating. Of meditation. He's telling us the importance of just taking some time out and thinking about the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he says, تَفَكَّرُوا فِي كُلِّ شَيْءٍ وَلَا تَفَكَّرُوا فِي ذَاتِ اللَّهِ. He says, think, ponder, and reflect upon the things of Allah. Think about everything. وَلَا تَفَكَّرُوا فِي ذَاتِ اللَّهِ. Don't think about the being of Allah. Don't think about Allah Himself. Think about the creation of Allah. In this beautiful season of ours, autumn and fall coming right now, where we get to see the changes of the creation of Allah, we get to see the beauty of the creation of Allah, it is a very beautiful moment for two things. Reflection and repentance. Reflection and repentance. Allah created this month in a way, or this season in a way, where we can see the changes in the creation of Allah. And we can, and the wind and the breeze that we can feel, the coolness of the air, makes it easy for us, for someone to just sit outside and feel the air and to ponder upon the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Before the first ayah was revealed, before the first verse was revealed, as Khadija radiallahu anha, or the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or Khadija radiallahu anha, will prepare the meal, or prepare the food for the journey. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would go and leave his house for months, and he would go and just sit in seclusion in the cave of Hira. He would just sit there. All he would do is ponder and reflect. Allah was preparing him for something great. Allah was preparing him for something great. Umar bin Abdul Aziz rahmatullahi alayhi says, Al-fikratu fi ni'amillah min afdal al-ibadah. Thinking or pondering is from amongst the blessings of Allah. It is better, it is from amongst the best ibadat. Abbas radiallahu an, or Hassan rahmatullahi alayhi says, tafakkar, or thinking and taking some time out to think of Allah for just a few moments, khayrun min qiyam al-layl. It is better than staying awake at night and performing ibadah. Why? Why is this so important? Why is this such a big deal? Because look, when we perform ibadah, when we perform salah, we have so many thoughts going on in our mind. How many of us can even ponder upon the words of Allah? When we say, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, how many of us even understand what is being said? Our brain, our mind is so occupied with work and business and school, and so many other things are coming to our mind that we can't clear it up. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, right when he would wake up, when he would wake up for tahajjud, what would be the first thing he would recite? He would recite the dua, but what the first ayahs the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would recite are these ayahs of Surah Ali Imran. Inna fi khalqi samawati, all the way to the end of the surah. And every morning when he would wake up, he would recite these ayahs of Surah Ali Imran. Just take out a few moments in the morning. Before you go to work, before you go to school, just take out 5, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, whatever it is, and just sit down and think for a few seconds. Just think. Reflect upon the creation of Allah. Remember the blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just take some time out. Just relax. Unplug from this world. Unplug from this world and just think about Allah. How do we think about Allah? We think about the creation of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just a few days ago, I read 2-3 articles. And in both those articles, it was about highly successful people. And unfortunately, success in our mind is not the one who has a close connection with Allah, is the one who has the most wealth. So the articles were referring to those people who are successful in this, from the perspective of the angle of this world. Who are they? And they were talking about the daily habits of these people. And both articles that I read, both articles had the same exact thing. Each person, each one of these successful people would take out 10 to 15 minutes just to meditate. And before they would go to work, or the rush of the day, before the rush of the day, they would take out 10 to 15 minutes. Some people said 20 minutes in the morning. Some people said 20 minutes in the morning and 20 minutes at night. They would take this time out and just disconnect from this world before they would start this day. Why? Because right now, what do? We wake up, we might look at our phone, we might look at our mini missed call, text messages, emails, or whatever. Right from the get-go, our mind is occupied in something. When you finish one task, you gotta work on another task. When you finish your homework, you gotta work on something else. When you're done with college, you have to go somewhere else. When you're done with work, you have to go work out, you have to exercise. Your mind is constantly occupied in doing things. You don't let your mind relax. Just for a few moments, let your mind relax and think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ibn Kathir rahmatullahi alayhi. And another important thing about reflecting and taking out time to think about the creation of Allah is before you leave your house, everything should remind you of Allah. Everything should remind, you know the word al-alam? Al-alam in the Arabic language is what we call the world. Rabbil alameen. Alameen is the plural of alam. Alam itself in the singular form translates as world or universe. And the plural form would be alameen, would mean universes or worlds. So Allah is the Lord of all the universes. The word alam comes from the Arabic word, or the root word is called alam. And the Arabic language, alam means a sign. Like a stop sign or a flag. Allah uses the word alam to refer to world, telling us indirectly that everything in this world is a sign back to Allah. Everything in this world, Allah, رَبَّنَا مَا خَلَقْتَ هَذَا بَاطِلًا. Anything that Allah created is not useless. There's a purpose behind everything Allah created. Even if it is something haram and wrong to do or to eat, everything is a sign back to Allah. So before we leave this world, prepare our minds that whatever we see reminds us of Allah. Ibn Kathir rahmatullahi alayhi, he says that one scholar he narrates, he says, إِنِّي لَأَخْرُجُ مِنْ مَنْزِلِي. Whenever I would leave my house, فَمَا يَقَعُ بَشَرِي عَلَى شَيْءٍ إِلَّا رَأَيْتُ لِلَّهِ نِعْمَةً. Anything that I would see, إِلَّا رَأَيْتُ لِلَّهِ فِيهِ نِعْمَةً. Anything that I would see, anything that I would lay my eyes upon, my eyes would not see anything except that they reminded me of the blessing of Allah. And وَلِي فِيهِ عِبْرَةً. And in this thing that I'm looking at, whatever it is a blessing of Allah, and there's a lesson for me in this. Rabia, the great worshipper, the famous worshipper, rahmatullahi alayha, al-adawiyya rahmatullahi alayha, she says, مَا سَمِعْتُ الْأَذَانِ إِلَّا ذَكَرْتُ مَنَادِيَ الْقِيَامَةِ. They would prepare their minds that whatever happened, whatever things they would hear, whatever things they would see, would remind them of Allah. She says that every time I heard the azan, it would remind me of the one of the caller on the Day of Judgment. وَرَأَيْتُ الثَّلْجَ. I wouldn't see snow falling, except that I would remember the papers, you could say, the papers from the books of deeds on the Day of Qiyamah, just scattering themselves and flying in the air. And I wouldn't see a swarm of locusts or animals or insects, except that I would remember the day of Qiyamah and the Hashr, where everyone will be on the plain of Arafah. So everything would be a reminder of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. A great poet said, إِذَا الْمَرْءُ كَانَتْ لَهُ فِكْرَةٌ فَفِي كُلِّ شَيْءٍ لَهُ عِبْرَةٌ. And a person can control his mind when he's able to reflect upon the creation of Allah and he has full control of his mind, then everything that he sees, there's a lesson for him in it. Everything that he lays upon his eyes lay upon, there's a reminder for him. But why is this a good time to start? Why, if you look outside, you can see the alternation of the days and night. You can see the creation of Allah. The leaves are falling. The leaves are changing. You can see the beauty of Allah. Unfortunately, in Atlanta, we don't have snow, so we don't get to see the beauty of snow. And really, it is very beautiful. I'm pretty sure you guys have seen snow before. But when I first went to Buffalo, I was so excited to see the snow. And after 2 days, I realized the snow never goes away, and then I was tired of it. But at the end of the day, without a doubt, if you were to look outside of your window, without a doubt, everyone would be amazed by the beauty of this. It's the white snow, how beautiful it shines. It would make everything look beautiful. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he says, "Ash-shita'u rabi'u al-mu'min." And because of daylight saving times, it seems like a very good time to narrate these things too. Ash-shita'u rabi'u al-mu'min. Winter, in our case, fall, is a time of harvesting for the Muslims. Why? طال ليله فقامه وقشر نهاره فشامه. طال ليله, the days are night, the nights are long. So it's easy to do what? To stand up in Qiyam al-Layl. Why is it easy? Because in reality, we're supposed to be sleeping after Salatul Isha. Salatul Isha in here in this masjid is performed at 7:30. We can go to sleep, get a good 6 to 7 hours of sleep, and still wake up for tahajjud. And for those who want to fast, the days are short, so it's easy to fast. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhi narrates something similar. Marhaban bishita. He said every time the month of the season of winter would come, he would say, welcome winter. The rahmah of Allah descends. Amma layluhu fatawilun lilqa'im. He said the nights are long for those who want to stand up in front of Allah. Anna naharuhu, and the days are short for those who want to fast. But as I said, there's two things that this season allows us to create quality. Two qualities that we can have is to reflect and to repent. One time the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam marra bi shajaratin. He passed by a tree, yabisat al-waraqa, and the leaves were dry. The leaves were dry. فضربها, he hit it بأصاه. He hit the tree with his stick. فتناثر الورق. And the leaves fell. All the leaves fell. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after doing this, said to the Sahaba radiallahu anhu, إن الحمد لله وسبحان الله ولا إله إلا الله والله أكبر. He said, لتساقط من ذنوب العبد كما تساقط ورق هذه من شجر من هذه هذه الشجرة. He said the sins of a slave fall off of him just like these leaves fell off this tree. Just like these leaves fell off this tree. That is, in reality, that is how easy it is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive anyone. Literally, isn't that this example, Allah can forgive us even faster than that. And many people, they feel like if we sin too much, there's no repentance for us. But we don't understand that repentance is a key reason why Allah created us. Repentance, doing tawbah, is a key reason why Allah created us. Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu, he says that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَالَّذِي نَفْسِ بِيَدِهِ لَوْ لَمْ تُذْنِبُ لَذَهَبَ اللَّهُ بِكُمْ. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, what did he say? He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَوْ لَمْ تُذْنِبُ. Talking to the companions radiallahu anhum ajma'in, and he said to them, لَوْ لَمْ تُذْنِبُ. If you don't sin. Now I'm not saying sin. كُلُّ بَنِي آدَمَ خَطَّان. We all, by nature, we sin. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, لَوْ لَمْ تُذْنِبُ. If you did not sin, لَذَهَبَ اللَّهُ بِكُمْ, then Allah will get rid of you. وَلَجَاءَ بِكَوْمٍ يُذْنِبُ, and He'll bring a nation that sins, فَيَسْتَغْفِرُونَ اللَّهُ, and then they ask Allah to forgive them, فَيَغْفِرُوا لَهُمْ, so Allah may forgive them. Allah is at-tawwab. Allah loves to forgive. Allah loves repentance. But Allah can only forgive us when you ask Him for forgiveness. And you only ask for forgiveness when you do something wrong. So by human nature, we will sin. Imam Ghazali rahmatullahi explains. He said, angels, Allah created two types of nations, two types of beings. One are those who don't sin, and the second one is those who sin. The ones who don't sin are the angels. And they are perfect in the sense that they don't sin. They are perfect in the sense that they don't sin. They don't disobey Allah. But remember, the best of creation are human beings. And there are those nations that don't, those are that being that doesn't sin. That being are the angels. They never sin. They're perfect creations of Allah. They're perfect beings of Allah. Then Allah created beings that sin. Jinns and human beings. Now the ones who sin have two choices. They will sin. By nature we will sin, no matter what we do. كُلُّ بَنِي آدَمَ خَطَّعُونَ. Every child of Adam, son of Adam, will sin. And the best of those who sin are those who repent. So we will sin. But from amongst the ones who sin, there can be two types. Either they will be like Iblis, they will sin and they won't repent. Like Shaitan, they will sin and they won't repent. Or they will be like our father Adam alayhi salatu wasalam, they will do a wrong act and they will repent. So by nature we will sin. That the question is, are we from amongst the people who follow Iblis, or are we amongst the people who follow Adam alayhi salatu wasalam? So by nature, no matter what we do, we will sin. In another hadith, a man once came to Rabia and he asked her a question. He said to her that I have committed a lot of sins. Will Allah forgive me? And she gave a very beautiful answer. She said, Allah, he said, do you not see, she said to him, that do you not see that Allah invites those who turn away from him? Allah invites those who turn away from him. Those people who aren't even thinking about Allah. Allah invites those people. Then why wouldn't he accept the repentance of those who actually turn to him? Allah invites those who turn away from him. Why wouldn't he accept the repentance of those who turn towards him? Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said in a hadith, which was also narrated by Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu, Wallahi inni la astaghfirullah wa atubu ilay fil yawmi akthar min 70 marra. He says, I swear by Allah that I turn towards Allah and I beg Allah for forgiveness. I say astaghfirullah wa atubu ilay in a day more than 70 times. Every day I ask Allah to forgive me more than 70 times in a day. In another hadith very similar to these wordings, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he said, Ya ayyuhan nas, tubu ila Allah, fa inni atubu ilayhi fil yawmi mi'ata marra. He says, O mankind, O people, turn towards Allah. For I turn towards Allah, I say astaghfirullah in a day more than, I say astaghfirullah more than 100 times in a day. And we aren't even close to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Just take maybe one of those tasbih counters, all those tasbihats that you can hold, or make a habit of saying astaghfirullah, at least astaghfirullah 70 to 100 times in a day. That's the least we can do. Just simple as that. Astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah, astaghfirullah. It's that simple. Oh, yeah, astaghfirullah, wa atubu ilayh. Ask Allah to forgive me and I turn to Him. So either we can do inaba, like Adam alayhi salatu wasalam did, which means to turn to Allah, or we can do inad like Iblis did and reject and rebel against Allah, which is to not ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive us. So just to make it easy for us, just to take a few points home. Number one is, take out a few minutes of your day to just unplug from this world. Just unplug. Don't think about anyone else. Don't think about anything else, not work, not business, not school, not even your homework. Nothing. Just take out, unplug from this world. No video games, nothing on your mind. Just ponder upon the creation of Allah. And what does that help us do? It helps us gain the ma'rifah of Allah. It gives us gain the recognition of Allah. It allows us to appreciate the blessings of Allah. وَإِن تَأَدُّ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. It allows us to appreciate the blessings that Allah has given us. It allows us to acknowledge our mistakes. You know, if a person's very angry and he's getting in a fight right now, at that time he can't think. But if that person were to just take a moment and just sit down and stop thinking about the argument, stop thinking about whatever useless discussion he had, which has zero importance to his life, and a few moments, that situation and incident will be over with. Just take down a few seconds, sit down and think about what you're doing. At that moment, in the heat of the fight, a person can't think. But if that person were to just calm down, he'll regret everything he just did. He'll regret everything he just did. So it allows us to appreciate the blessings of Allah. It allows us to acknowledge our mistakes. And when we acknowledge our mistakes, it becomes easy for us to turn to Allah and beg Allah to forgiveness. Beg Allah for forgiveness. So the third thing is that we say astaghfirullah at least 70 to 100 times. And those tasbih counters make your life 100 times easier. it makes it very easy. And if you get a habit of it, just put it on your finger and just keep saying astaghfirullah and don't even look at it. By the time you know it, you'll probably be at 500, and the next time you look at it, you'll be at 1,000. May Allah give us the tawfiq to act upon these beautiful teachings of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and use the seasonal changings. These changes that we see from the creation of Allah, may Allah allow us to take benefit from it. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us the tawfiq to turn to Him, to reflect upon His creation, to do that tafakkur, or yatafakkaruna fi khalqi samawati wa ala, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was referring to in this ayah. Jazakum Allahu khayran wa akhir da'wana alhamdulillahi rabbil alameen. We'll have a few moments for sunnahs inshaAllah, and then we'll have the Arabic khutbah inshaAllah.